Hey, what's up, Internet? Happy Thursday. Sorry about the delay. It turns out that I was recording, but not streaming, which is kind of an important step in the whole streaming process. What's up, Koss? I just got done doing the daily challenge for the 9th. That resets at 7 p.m. my time, so I just wanted to get that out of the way before I started the stream. And I was doing really well. Number 371 in the world. Just wanted to show off a little bit. And then I killed myself like an idiot with the scepter in level 1 of the temple. C'est la vie. So yeah, last time during the stream, I finally conquered Olmec. After dozens of attempts. Well, hundreds of attempts. Dozens of hours of practice. And, well, it's time to start thinking about taking on hell. Not much, Cuss. Trying not to freeze recently. I mean, I'm not sure how bad it is where you live, but the U.S. has had quite the cold snap recently. My pipes froze for a couple days here, which kind of sucked. Luckily, they did not break or anything. I was just unable to use water for a couple days, which isn't the end of the world, I guess. Coldest it got here was about minus 10 or so Fahrenheit, not counting wind chill and all that. Which, you know, there are some places in the U.S. and especially Canada where it got down to like minus 40, so I guess I should count my blessings. So yeah, a hell run is quite a bit different than a normal run. You really have to think about money more than you do if your only goal is to beat Olmec. Mostly because it requires you to buy the Ankh, which costs 50,000 gold in every playthrough. So, you know, normally I wouldn't be quite so thorough in, you know, checking every pot, getting every little piece of money I can. But, If you're going to try to do hell, it's really a requirement to pay attention to your wallet. Now, some people they say screw the money. They just kill all the shopkeepers. I'm not quite good enough to do that yet. I might have to get good enough to do that if I want any chance of taking on hell. I don't know. But till then, my strategy of getting as much money as possible seems to be working okay. As a general baseline, you want to get about 10,000 in every level. Wow, I don't know how that spider didn't hit me. If you get 10,000 gold in every level, like in 1-1 through 1-4, and then also get 10,000 gold in 2-1, then you're guaranteed to have enough to buy the Ankh. Of course, it's better to have more than that if at all possible, but that's kind of the minimum you're shooting for. I have not actually made it to hell yet. I made it to the City of Gold twice. Now see, normally I'd be scrambling to get enough money to buy that jetpack, or I just steal it, but not today. The City of Gold is the secret area you have to access before you can access hell. To get to the City of Gold, you have to buy the Ankh in the black market, which pretty much requires getting the chest and the key while you're in the mines, so you know where the black market is. Once you buy the Ankh, you have to kill yourself in a certain level in the ice caves, so you resurrect inside the stone Moai head, and that gives you a special item that you need to access the City of Gold. And once you're in the City of Gold, you have to get the Book of the Dead, which allows you to access hell. And the first time I made it to the City of Gold, I was like almost dead, so I was panicking and I just kind of rushed my way through the level, and I totally forgot that I had to get the Book of the Dead, which, you know, you would think if I make it that far, I wouldn't forget quite a vital step like that. But you know, it's kind of intimidating the first time you you finally reach it. You know, you spend all this time building up and building up, and you know, I mean, it's a process that starts from the beginning of the game, basically. You know, from the first moment you start playing a new playthrough, your actions are important. And once that series of events finally comes to fruition, you know, it's a pretty big deal. And the second time I made it to the City of Gold, I was almost dead, and I went to try to bomb to get the Book of the Dead. I said City of Gold, right? Okay. I thought I said City of the Dead. I might have. I don't know. But I bombed the wall to try to get the Book of the Dead, since it's always kind of encased in its own separate little area. And something flew from the explosion and hit me, and I died. So, yeah. My main goal at this point is to make it to hell. I don't expect I'm going to be able to actually beat hell for a pretty long time. But if I can make it to hell, I'll be feeling pretty good about myself. What's up, Chris247 in the chat? The cold weather moved from Europe, Russia to the U.S. Usually we have that kind of weather, but this year there's just no snow at all. Just shitload of rain. Yeah, it's been a... this winter's been crazy, man, in the U.S. Like, on the first day of winter, on the 21st, I think the high that day was like 70 degrees. And that didn't last long, obviously. But, it's been up and down. You know, it's been a winter of dramatic highs and lows for us. Finally got above freezing. Well, I guess it didn't get above freezing yesterday, but it at least got warm enough for my pipes to unfreeze, which is good because that would have been 3 days in a row without a shower instead of just two. But I was able to take one this morning. And then today, it got up above freezing. It was like the high 30s, maybe the low 40s, using our crazy imperialist measurement system. Oh, what happened to the dog? Oh, God. That's weird. He's just lying there dead. Oh, I guess he got hit by one of those arrows. Yeah, that makes sense. All right, doing pretty good on money so far. Not quite as good as I would like, but it's possible I'll be able to buy the Ankh. Of course, you might have more time to buy the Ankh than just five levels. The Ankh, or the entrance to the black market, can spawn anywhere between, it's either jungle level 1, 2, or 3. It never spawns in 4, because if it spawned in 4, then that would take you to the, ice caves, and the black market can't be in the ice caves. But yeah, all the snow's pretty much melted at this point. There are a few stragglers. I just had a huge cup of terrible gas station coffee, so you know, I'm ready to roll today. I have all my wits about me. Crap. Well, let's see if I can do this without pissing off that shotgun guy. This is awfully close to that area. Okay, good. Unfortunately, I still don't have anywhere close to enough money. So let's explore around a little bit first. I'm gonna have to use some ropes to get back up here. Alright, see if I can do this without killing myself. So, since beating Olmec for the first time, I've employed a few different strategies that have worked out pretty well. One is focusing more so on sacrificing the damsels than rescuing them, if at all possible. Because the item that you get for sacrificing two damsels is well worth it. The, I think it's pronounced Kapala or Kapala, or something like that. That makes it so you regain health by hitting enemies and drinking their blood. It's pretty gruesome, actually. But you get that. See, I thought you had to sacrifice way more damsels to get that item. It turns out you only have to sacrifice two. So, it's definitely worth it. Of course, if you don't have the ability to sacrifice them, then, you know, saving them is the next best thing. These big frogs usually have spring shoes. So, crap, I still don't have sticky bombs either. That sucks. Okay. It's not a guaranteed thing that they will have sticky bombs. Crap. Alright. Let's get out of here. Well, okay. I barely have enough money. That's, it's pretty good that I picked up that idol, actually. And sorry, damsel. Oh, crap. Alright. Well, that could have gone worse. Hello, Twisted Little Heart. And what's up, Galen? Alright, the black market. I actually don't know how many times I've gotten the black market during a stream. Usually I don't worry about it too much, since up until this point I wasn't actively trying to get to hell. I'm still using the classic soundtrack mod, but the black market music is actually a really good track. Like, I don't dig all the music in this game, but the black market actually has really good music. I would recommend looking it up on YouTube or something if you haven't heard it. I do like the classic jungle music though, because it reminds me of Whip Rush for the Sega Genesis. Not really sure why. It doesn't even have that much in common with it, but like the opening theme music to Whip Rush kind of hits that same chord. So, I'm not sure if there are any Giant Bomb fans watching, but Patrick from Giant Bomb recently started doing daily Spelunky playthroughs. And that's been pretty interesting to watch. He had the Olmec in his very first stream. Lucky bastard. But he died in a pretty spectacular fashion. Maybe a similar sound font. I don't know. I'm not really sure what a sound font is. Another good reason to sacrifice damsels instead of rescuing them is because you're always guaranteed to get a gift on the first sacrifice. And, you know, that alone is pretty good. That was a risk. I should not have attacked that bat while I was standing on that pot. Ooh. But it worked out for me. I'm playing a Spelunket. Yeah, I, up until this point, I was just sticking with the classic Spelunker character. No real reason. typically when a game offers you multiple characters and they don't play any differently, I usually just stick with the default, just for tradition, I guess. It's the same reason I, whenever I play an RPG, I always leave the characters' names the same, because, you know, who cares? I don't want to spend time coming up with the name of a character. But, you know, I thought I'd change it up a little bit and, you know, get a little more variety going on. Oh, come on. There we go. Unfortunately, now I'm going to have to use a rope to get my way, to make my way back out of here. Or a bomb, I guess. Yeah, I have more ropes than bombs, so let's head back up and see what I can find. Classic music is so much better than the new music. Yeah, I agree for the most part. But that Black Market track, it's pretty off the chain. I like the mines because the idols are so easy to get. I mean, or not the mines, the jungle, because the idols are so easy to get. In the mines, it's never worth risking getting the idol because you can never be 100% sure if the level is devoid of shopkeepers or not. I mean, unless you go down to the bottom of the level and then make your way back up, which, screw that, unless you have a jetpack, of course, but I would not want to waste ropes doing that. Don't really have to worry about money too much anymore now that we have the Ankh. Would be nice to get some more bombs, which I think I might do. Crap. The shop coming up here. When you're doing a hell run, you don't really have to worry about health too much, as long as you can make it to the ice caves, because, guys, gonna ruin my good time. Because when you kill yourself and revive, you're just gonna come back with 4 health anyway. So there's no point in fretting too much over getting a ton of health. Oh crap, I could have just sold the idol to that shopkeeper. I always forget you can do that. Hello, Aferol. Why not just name a character after yourself? I don't know. Kind of takes you out of the experience. I mean, this story isn't about me, man. It's about Cloud Strife. I like both musics pretty equally. The original was really catchy, and the new one feels pretty relaxing. Yeah, that's true. I don't know. The new music is almost too relaxing, if you know what I mean. Doesn't give the proper sense of tension, I don't think. Except for like the boss music. The boss music is like the old mech music is pretty tense. Okay. I don't know how good of an idea this is, but I want to try something. Yeah, there we go. Hopefully this won't mess up my run too much. But I recently learned of the existence of the worm level. And I wanted to check it out. I actually checked it out once during my daily challenge previously. Wow, I had the music turned down for the daily challenge because I was listening to something else. This music is pretty good too. I'm assuming this is original crap because I don't think the worm level existed in classic Spelunky. At least I know those red tongue things didn't exist. See, I was almost eaten by the red tongue thing once. And I thought all it would do is kill me, so I kind of jumped off before it could eat me. And then since that only happened once, I was like, man, what the heck was that? And I looked it up, and I learned about the existence of the worm level. Crap! Of course, last time, the one time I played the worm level previously, I used the tongue exit in the mines, rather than the one in the ice cave, or not the mines, the jungle. I don't know why I keep doing that. And, this seems quite a bit more difficult, actually. But, you know, nothing ventured, nothing gained. This is why you come to the worm level. It's called the Chris Knife. It is a weapon that replaces your whip, so you don't actually have to hold it in your hands like you do every other weapon. And it can kill any enemy in the game in one hit. Except the enemies that can't actually be killed. So Olmec, the Ghost, and I think the Magma Man. It doesn't work on them. And I've taken quite a bit of damage trying to get this, but I wanted to at least show it off. Those green orb things that are traveling along the walls, you can't kill them at all with the whip. You have to have the Chris Knife, or hit them with the bomb or something. I think it's Chris Knife. It's CrysKnife. I don't think it's Christ Knife. That would be a little weird. I think it's implying that it's made out of crystal. So yeah, I probably wouldn't risk doing this normally if I was actually trying to do a hell run. But you know, since I was streaming and everything, I wanted to show it off, because I've never shown it off on the stream before. But see, the last time I came here, I had the Kapala, or the crap, or the Kapala, or whatever. So my survivability was actually a lot greater. Okay, well, this is not going to be a successful hell run. Okay, good. I still have the knife. But you know, I might be able to turn this into another Olmec kill. Because I'm still doing okay. I have 22 bombs. They're not sticky, but there's still time to remedy that. Actually, there might not be, since the giant spiders don't really show up after the mines. I guess I might run into a shopkeeper that sells them, but like these yetis that you normally can't whip at all. One hit, and they are meat chunks. It doesn't just kill anything in one hit, it gives it as well. Music is kind of freaking me out. Sounds vaguely Metroid-ish. I like it though. I like it more than most of the new music for the game. Alright, well, we made it out alive. Is there a ghost on the worm level? You know, I don't know. I guess not, because I was in that level for 4 minutes and 25 seconds. Of course, the worm level counts as 2 levels, so it might come after 5 minutes. Since normally it comes after 2.5 minutes. See, I entered the worm levels on 3-1, and now I'm on 3-4. Ah, crap. Die, mammoth. Those mammoths are usually such a pain in the ass if you have to actually kill one. I'm not actually going to go to the alien mothership. I just want to get that crate and this dog. Oh. Never mind. So yeah, I've killed Olmec twice now. Once during the live stream, and then once during a failed hell attempt. Isn't there always a ghost? Yeah, I mean, except when you're fighting Olmec. But I'm pretty sure my theory is probably correct. I don't have sticky bombs. That's okay. If I can get close enough to this guy, I won't need sticky bombs. Crap. Of course, I don't have the required item, so I don't actually have to kill that guy at all. I really don't like not having sticky bombs. Oh yeah, you can't whip things off the edge when you don't have a whip. Oh, well, guess I do have these non-sticky bombs. Good for something, probably. So yeah, in the future, I probably won't go to the worm level if I'm actually trying to do a hell run. But, you know, it's good to see as much of the game as you can. I've watched an interview with John Romero recently, and he said that Jib is supposed to be pronounced... Oh. DJIB. I'm assuming that's just Jib. That's like your phonetic way of spelling Jib. Yeah, well, the word comes from giblets, right? And I think that's supposed to be pronounced with a soft G rather than a hard one. Ah, crap. Well, I'm dead. Oh, well. Oh, I'm not dead. Amazing. Yeah, that would be the entrance to the City of Gold if I had the Khajiit, or whatever it's called. Oh, great. Dark level. Exactly what I wanted. God, stuff in the temples is so hard to kill when you don't have sticky bombs. I don't know where that bomb went. Oh, it just went right through him. Well, I cannot bounce on these guys to death. I can't get into position to hit them with my knife. So I guess I'll just come down here. Without a torch. Seems like a foolproof plan, huh? I guess I shouldn't have thrown my torch at those guys. Oh, I thought I was dead. Yeah, that thing. Oh. Oh well. So yeah, that was the worm level. Let's not go there again. I mean, I would like to have the Chris knife for when you fight the boss of hell, because it can kill the boss of hell in one hit as well. I think his name is King Yama. Because he takes damage just like any normal enemy. Now, it won't kill Olmec in one hit, because Olmec is not susceptible to damage. But the boss of hell works on him. Ah, crap. Should have whipped that coin off the edge. Oh, well. So I'm definitely playing better, like, as a whole. Like, I've put so much practice into this game, I feel like I am tangibly better at it than I used to be. Which is good. That's a really good feeling to have. Now, in a game like Rogue Legacy, which I still really like, that's probably my game of the year for 2013. But in Rogue Legacy, it's not really rewarding the same way that Spelunky is. Because if you just keep beating your head against it long enough, then eventually you'll get the best of Rogue Legacy. Like, if you just keep playing and playing and playing, then, you know, you'll level up your abilities, and you will, your character will get better. But in Spelunky, your character doesn't get better, you get better. And that's kind of the difference between those two games for me. I still like them both a lot. Damn, Duke, you're quite a Spelunky fanatic. Yeah, well, I've been spending a lot of time playing while I listen to podcasts, or while I listen to other LPs or video game streams. Because it's a great game for that, too. I just turn the sound down in the game. And, you know, because you don't really need the sound, and you don't really need to give it, I don't know, the way you play the game, I don't want to say you don't have to give it your full attention, because you really do, but, like, it's a different kind of attention than the attention you spend listening to a podcast or something. Oh, hey, what's up, CPC Gamer? Long time no see. How's it been? Oh, who's Mr. Pink Text? I'm using an IRC client, so I literally don't see color when it comes to other people. Crap. I don't know where the key is. Alright, well, let's start looking for it, I guess. This is the worst part about doing a hell run. Sometimes you get lucky, and the key and the chest are just right next to each other. But sometimes you have to go looking for it, and you have to use a whole bunch of resources to explore the whole level. Sometimes you still can't find it before the ghost shows up. At least I can rescue that dog now, especially since I just got hit. And there's the key. Let's see. If I bombed up here, it would take two bombs to get through, so hopefully I can leave room for my... Okay. Yeah, this will work. Oh, on Twitch, your username is pink. That's good. On Twitch, my username is this unreadable neon green color. It's really hideous. I could probably get that idol, too, since I don't believe there was a shop. Aw, crap. I thought I could make that fall. Alright. Of course, if I do get the idol, then I'm going to have to make two trips. One for the idol and one for the key. But I guess since I used all these ropes and stuff, I might as well get as much value out of them as possible. Well, scratch that. Can I make this fall? Yeah, okay. So I was one block too high to survive if I just fell. What's up, Ultra Kirby 64? Aw, man. Would you look at this shit? Oh, at least I can jump over here. Of course, it's my own fault for not carrying something into the level with me. ABC. Always be carrying. That is a very nice item to find in a crate. I listened to a little bit. Ah, crap. Why did I throw that pot? That was going to be my trap triggering pot. Oh, I'll just go down this way, I guess. But yeah, I listened to a little bit of Awesome Games Done Quick while I was playing Spelunky. The speedrunning marathon that's going on right now. I don't know, that's not such a great listening thing, since like the commentary is so much based around like what's going on in the actual game. But it's been fun. I watched the Yoshi's Island speedrun by a guy named Trihex. That was insane. Crap. And I watched the Super Mario World speedrun race. That was also pretty insane. Mostly I've been listening to a playthrough of Dark Souls by a guy named Jeff Green. And that's good, like, background entertainment for why you play Spelunky, because he just talks about... He's kind of like me. He talks about all kinds of random stuff while he plays. A lot of AGDQ is watching it and going, holy crap, when you see the glitches. Yeah, that's definitely part of it. I think the fourth area looks harder compared to the classic Spelunky. Oh, the temple? I actually don't know, because I never made it that far in classic Spelunky. It's really sad when you think about how much I played classic Spelunky, but furthest I ever made it in that was the ice caves. I'm doing really, really bad on health. I could go to the worm level again. But see, the thing about going to the worm level in the jungle is that since the worm level is it's two levels in one, and the entrance to the worm level, crap, I was talking too much. The entrance to the worm level always spawns in the first area, and it's only in the jungle or the ice caves. So either 2-1 or 3-1, those are your only opportunities to enter the worm level. And if you go in the jungle, then like I was saying, since it's two levels, then you have a chance of missing the, you're guaranteed to miss the black market. So yeah, you cannot do both the black market and the worm level. It's one or the other. I guess I should have thought of that before I went to the worm level the first time. Because the black market, once you get to, Come on. Piece of crap. Of course, the one time I actually want the bat to attack, it's not going to. But yeah, that kind of sucks. So why do they say the Krishna can kill King Yama in one hit if it's impossible to get to hell if you also go to the worm level? Because you have to go to the black market to get the Ankh. Huh. That's kind of weird. I did not really think about that. I mean, maybe there's like a hack or an exploit or something that will allow you to do both. I really don't know. Have I seen, heard any of Sam's stuff at AGDQ? That's, former YouTube star SS Skinner. No, I haven't. I knew she was there. I didn't know she was involved in it in any way this year. That's pretty cool. You're visiting her in April or May. You're kind of hyped. Oh, that's awesome. I hope you have an excellent trip, sir. Apparently, like, they actually open up... I don't know if they always did this, but they open up AGDQ to spectators. You can pay... crap. You can pay for a ticket to show up and just watch, which I think is pretty cool. Tickets are a little pricey. Actually, I'm not sure how much they cost, because I didn't realize you had that option until it already started. I think I read somewhere that it was like $40 to visit for a day or something. Which, I mean, for a convention or something, that's fine. I don't know if I would pay that just to hang out and watch people play video games. I mean, not that it doesn't look like a fun time, but, you know, I mean, for me, there'd be, like, travel costs involved and stuff. as well. So, not really practical for me. The main writer for Borderlands 2, Anthony Birch, tweeted that he was going to hang out during the Borderlands 2 speedrun, which I thought was pretty cool. I don't know if they're going to have him like Skype in, like they did with Edmund McMillan that one year, or if he's just going to hang out in the chat room. I definitely watched that one, but it's happening at like 4 a.m. tonight, or 4 a.m. tomorrow morning, and I have to work in the morning, so not an option for me. I think that if the community is right, it's worth it. I go to a con in Atlanta once a year. It's freaking amazing. Yeah, I mean, if I had the money, I'd definitely consider something like that. Like going to a big con or a big event like that. Like, I'd really like to go to MAGFest some year. You know, that's relatively close to me, and it looks like it would be a really cool time. Oh, for fuck's sake. But, you know, the cost of, really, the main cost for me would be lodging. Like, you can get a Greyhound bus ticket round trip for not a whole lot of money. Like, it actually wouldn't be much more than, like, gas would cost if someone made the same trip driving. But, like, actually getting a hotel, especially if you wanted to stay more than one day for a con or something. And, you know, I definitely would, because why would you travel somewhere just to do something for one day? That's kind of lame. Although I am getting a raise this year. So, that might be something worth considering in the future. It's not like an I'm awesome kind of raise. It's more that, I'm a state employee, and all state employees are getting a raise this year. It's not a big one, but, it's better than nothing. I mean, I am awesome. That's just not why I'm getting the raise. Oh, things already triggered. I was going crazy trying to avoid triggering that. Fuck, this is a lot of spiders. Okay. Maybe I should go this way. I have all these bombs. And there is a damsel over here. Alright, sticky bombs. Awesome. I've got the potential for promotion and raise in the works, says CBC Gamer. Oh, congrats. Fuck, I'm gonna have to use 3 bombs if I wanna get through here. Oh well. It's better than trying to go through those spiders, I guess. But yeah, MAGFest would probably be my, the number one convention I'd want to go to. PAX East might also be really cool, but that's kind of a huge convention, which, you know, is good, but I might want to start with something a little bit smaller. I mean, we have a small gaming convention here where I live called CharCon, and it's a lot of fun. I didn't go this previous year, or I didn't go in 2013 because I went to a concert that was being held on the same day, but it usually attracts about like 700 or 800 people, you know, not even a medium scale convention, but it's a pretty good time. Windows is bitching at me because my copy of Windows is not genuine. I may be a victim of software counterfeiting. I actually had a blue screen on me today, which is really weird. Windows 7 isn't supposed to blue screen, at least in theory. I think it's like the second time it's ever happened to me. So, hopefully, nothing like that happens during the stream. I haven't seen many altars this time around. Which I guess is okay, since I need to rescue these people to get my health back anyway, since I've been sucking. The one bad thing about playing Spelunky with the sound down is that you really have to pay attention to the eye to see if it flashes, since you can't hear it beep. You have to actually, you know, keep an eye on it, so to speak. Yeah, it's not worth using an item to get that gem, I don't think. Alright, Black Market is not on this level. I am pretty confident. One of the reasons I like Dragon Con over, say, Comic Con is that Dragon Con is a lot smaller. It's just a bunch of geeks hanging out, while Comic Con has more vendors and sales folk. Yeah, that's kind of what, why MAGFest would appeal to me. Because I hear it's a very small, you know, community focused sort of convention. So one thing that I'm curious about, it's possible to actually sacrifice yourself to the altar. Like if you fall from a great enough height to stun yourself, it'll say you sacrifice yourself, and there's like special text to go along with it. And it's a really hilarious way to die. But one thing I'm curious about is, I wonder what happens if you do that while you have the Ankh. So you sacrifice yourself, but then you revive. I wonder if anything special happens. Crap. If it does, don't tell me what it is. Because, you know, I want to be surprised. But if something does happen, something special does happen when you do that, then I would like to be made aware of it. So I don't waste my time trying to do that for no reason. Because now that I know about the worm level, and I know about, you know, the hell path and all that, I don't know if there are any secrets I still need to learn about this game. That could potentially be a cool secret to stumble across. But yeah, Dragon Con sounds like it would be fun too. I don't know, I always kind of thought that was more of a, like a D&D focused convention. Like it's more Wizards of the Coast stuff than just like general geekery. Like I'd much rather go to just a general convention. Or maybe I'm thinking of Gen Con. I don't know, those both happen in the South, I think. So I tend to get them kind of confused. Alright, I guess the Black Market is not on this level. I went pretty much all over the place, and I did not see nor hear blinking, so I'm really hoping I didn't miss anything. Okay, this is the last chance for the Black Market to show up. So, please tell me I did not miss it somehow. I will be pretty disappointed. Dragon Con is pop culture. Oh, okay. That's cool. Yeah. I would much rather, because one of my friends / family members was trying to get me to go to Origins. And I know that's like a very D&D focused kind of convention. And I don't know. I don't know if it's the sort of thing that I would enjoy. Yeah, Capella. Capella. I don't know. I mean, like I said, the main factor in whether I go to a big convention is, like, travel and stuff. Travel and lodging and all that. I mean, if I live near Origins or Dragon Con or anything like that, then, you know, heck yeah, I'd go, because why not? Oh, I still did not... Crap! I still did not hear the blinking. Or see the blinking. But, you know, I guess if CPC Gamer can fly from freaking England to go to a convention, I don't really have an excuse, do I? We don't have many conventions in the UK. See, that's kind of surprising, since it's such a smaller country than the US. I would think it would be easier to do, like, a large-scale convention, because people wouldn't have to come from nearly as far away, you know, relatively speaking. I mean, it's not a small country by any means, but I think I missed the black market. How the hell did I miss the black market? And the ghost is coming. Great. Well, I hope you guys are happy. You let me miss the black market. Oh well. Do you want me to start over, or do you want me to try to keep going and get another Olmec kill? I'd be okay either way. I mean, it's a shame to waste a good run, I guess. Hello, Rooster J. I don't know if you're still in the chat room or not. It's saying you left. By the way, how's the delay? Like, Twitch has been... Crap. Twitch has been kind of pissing some people off by adding a much longer delay than it used to have. I'm not sure if that's still in effect, or if that was a glitch, or if that was a feature. I don't know, I've heard a lot of conflicting information. I mean, I guess for a stream like this, having a delay doesn't matter as much. But like, Sam was trying to do a stream of the new Walking Dead game with viewer feedback, like having the people watching the stream make all the choices, and the delay was just making it impossible for her to do that. And it's kind of a bummer. When you have the Capella, it's better to just kill the damsels than it is to rescue them, because the amount of blood you get from them is better than the one health you would get for saving them. Hello, Gonzo101. I'm doing okay, thanks. Did you used to use a different name? Because I don't think I recognize your username. Of course, I'm terrible with names, so... If I have seen you before with that name, then I apologize. Well, I guess since I'm not doing a hell run, I could try doing the worm level again. I don't know. The worm level was really fucking hard. There's a lot of shit going on in it. Hope this guy's selling more bombs. That'd be pretty ace. Oh, man. You have exactly what I need, good sir. And I still have a pretty good bit of money left, huh? Alright, let's see if I can turn this into an Olmec kill. I watched on Xbox for a long time. Excuse me. I might have been in the chat once or twice, but it was a long time ago. Okay, well, welcome. Always happy to see a new face, or an old face that's new to me. Newish. If it happens, you can travel to Atlanta for Dragon Con. You're welcome to a room with me and my friends. There's usually about four in a room. Oh, that's awesome. Thanks, dude. I appreciate the offer. When is Dragon Con? Oh, crap. Oh. I thought I was higher up than that. I didn't realize I was already that far or that close to the bottomless pit. Pretty ace. What are you, British now? Yeah, I'm a quarter British on my mother's side. That's not true. I don't think that's even a thing. But, you know, I've watched enough British television to, you know... I've grokked the lingo, my good friend. That's a British thing, right? Grok. The reason I haven't been able to watch is because they updated the Xbox version of Twitch, and now when you try to watch a stream, it's just a black screen with sound. That's it. Wow. That does not sound like a very useful Xbox application. They probably just want everyone to get an Xbox One. That's their little, that's how they get you. Hey, what's going on, Morse? Dragon Con is Labor Day weekend every year. So, that's September? Crap. I can never remember when Labor Day is. I always get it mixed up with, like, Memorial Day and stuff. It's one of those fake holidays. It's not fake. The labor movement is very important, but you know what I mean. Oh, come on. There we go. The problem about doing a run with all kinds of awesome items is that when you no longer have those items, it's hard to get used to. How goes the stream? Oh, it's going okay. I haven't made it even close to hell yet, but I've shown off some cool things. Last time I missed the black market somehow. Usually, as long as you have the eye, you're going to get close enough to the entrance where it'll start blinking slowly. So I don't know how I did not get close enough to it. Oh well. Oh, the first weekend in September. Okay, I got it. It's one of those rotating holidays. Or not rotating, but, you know what I mean. It's a fluid holiday. Kind of like Chinese New Year, which is on January 31st this year. So I thought of a really awesome stream for Chinese New Year if it was the Year of the Dragon. I had no idea what it actually was, but I thought, I wonder if it's the Year of the Dragon this year. Because if it is, I can do a marathon stream called the Year of the Wagon, and I could play Oregon Trail, and Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. But it turns out the last Year of the Dragon was 2012, and the next one isn't until 2024. So it'll be kind of a long time before I can do that little play on words. This year is the year of the horse. And I thought about doing some horse-themed games, but I couldn't think of any. Well, except for the text adventure Horse Master, which is a really great game, but text adventures don't seem to do that well in live stream format. If I had a good capture solution for PS2, I could do Shadow of the Colossus, since there's a pretty heavy horse element in that game. But alas, I do not. I could do Ocarina of Time, since it has Epona, but I don't really like that game. You said that you're a quarter British. What about the other three quarters? I'm a quarter... I don't know. I have no idea what I am, to be honest. I'm just kind of a generic white person. I mean, I'm sure I do have, like, Anglo-Saxon roots. Somewhat. But, I have no idea how much or, you know, in what ratio. I can play Red Dead Redemption. Well, unfortunately, they never made a PC version of that. Otherwise, I'd like to play it. I mean, I could play the Xbox version, but I would not be able to stream it. Unless I could actually get my capture device working, which I have not been able to reliably do so far. Boy, that was $100 down the drain. I got one of those Elgato capture devices, the HDMI pass-through kind, and like, I've gotten it working a couple times, but not reliably enough to actually stream with. I think my computer specs, like, aren't good enough. Like, I don't meet the minimum system requirements for it. Which, I don't know how I got it working at all, if that's the case. The correct answer is, I'm all awesome, says CBC Gamer. Yep, I'm a quarter awesome, half great, and a quarter super cool. That's my ancestry. Alright, don't let me miss the black market this time. I'm blaming you for that, chat room. Sense, as every professional gamer knows, you can never take responsibility for anything. It's always something else's fault. Like, if I die, I'm definitely going to blame my controller. I almost jumped right into those spikes. I don't usually use a bomb or a rope to rescue someone, unless I'm doing really bad on health. Now, if there's an altar on this level, then I would use bombs and ropes to sacrifice them. Since, I mean, it's just a really good value, because you get a gift the first time you sacrifice someone, and you get the Kapala the second time you sacrifice. Oh, for fuck's sake. And you can just get insane amounts of health once you have the Kapala. Like, if I get it, I regularly have like 9 or 10 health. Of course, I lose it all if I actually enter the Moai head. Want to lose all of it before. But, you know, it's nice for a little bit. And then once you make it to the temple, you know, it's a more reliable way to get some health. Alright. Well, I didn't hear any beeping, but I also didn't really explore that side of the jungle that much. Oh, crap. Wrong button. Of course, I don't have sticky bombs anyway, so I don't know what I was going to, what I was planning to do there. I thought I had sticky bombs. I personally don't like any Rockstar games, says Morris. I've heard a lot of good things about Bully and Red Dead Redemption. I think I might actually get some enjoyment out of those games if I played them. For fuck's sake. What terrible placement for these tiki heads. Since I don't have sticky bombs to take them out. Aw, man. My dude died. I mean, the Grand Theft Auto games are fun for what they are. Like, I've gotten enjoyment out of San Andreas, just like dicking around and blowing stuff up. But I've never actually played all the way through any of the Grand Theft Auto games. But I think that's pretty similar to most people's experience with those games. Making me nervous that I still have not seen any beeping. I also don't have enough money yet, which is kind of a bummer. Red Dead Redemption is basically GTA Horse Edition. But, I mean, isn't the story at least a little bit better in that game than it is in the Grand Theft Auto games? That's what I heard. Not that it would have to be amazing to be better than Grand Theft Auto. I really don't like not having sticky bombs. Still no black market. What level is this, 2? Alright, last chance. I like LA Noire, even though it wasn't at all what I was expecting. Yeah, I think I own that game on Steam, and I haven't touched it yet. It was one of those buy it for $5 during a sale kind of deals. Well, fuck. If this level actually has the black market entrance. Oh! There we go. Now, where the heck is it? Oh, you know, I see. I know where it is. It's right here. But I still don't have enough money, so let's see if I can grab a couple of these scarabs. That's not spikes down there, is it? I can't see. Crap. No, okay. It's just grass. I did a run through the other day where I got 50,000 gold in one level just thanks to the gold scarabs. Of course, I died like the level immediately after that, but it felt pretty damn good. I don't know where that scarab went. That was over on the left. Kind of lost track of it. But I have over 50,000 gold now, so I should stop pressing my luck and just get the heck out of here. Go here to find that guy. You just missed that guy. He went over there. Says CPC Gamer. Yeah, that's kind of the traditional Rockstar mission structure. Alright. Kind of have to be careful in the black market because it's really easy to accidentally piss off the shopkeepers. Like, normally... Oh... Oh, fuck you, Dracula. Look, he's taunting me. This is the Spelunky equivalent of teabagging me. That is uncalled for. okay. Well, at least I found the black market that time. I don't know what my problem was that one game. At least it was an amusing death. I really wish I was streaming that time. I accidentally sacrificed myself. Because that was really the best. It was in a dark level, so I couldn't see what was below me. And I was doing really well that playthrough. I had a good bit of health, like 5 or 6. And I just fell face first onto an altar, and Kali has accepted your sacrifice. She seems happy. See, that's why I want to know if anything special happens if you sacrifice yourself and then revive. I didn't notice any weird item spawn or anything like that. Yeah, Moors, if you fall onto the altar far enough for you to take damage and become stunned, you can sacrifice yourself. And I want to know if anything happens when you do that when you have the Ankh, so you can sacrifice yourself and then revive. I haven't read anything about it, but that would be kind of cool if they, like, programmed for that eventuality. One thing I'm trying to train myself to stop doing is killing enemies unnecessarily. Like, it's just gamer instincts that if I see an enemy, you know, even if there's no reason to kill it, no reason to go where the enemy is at all. Like, some enemy wants to just go over there and kill it anyway. Man, I haven't had any snake levels yet. The snake levels are usually really good. Fuck. Usually really good for getting money. Because you can always get a pickaxe. Or a mattock, I guess. And, if you have the eye, then you can see where all the gems in the level were buried. And you can get a lot of money that way. Alright. Let's go on ahead and kill that guy. And anger that other guy. Great. Spiders, the giant spiders are a pretty good source of money too, if you can kill them without, you know, significantly damaging yourself. Because they always drop gems. I've gotten better at killing the giant spiders. Like, I've realized that if you're stuck in a web, then for the purposes of the game, like, if you're stuck in a web and an enemy jumps into your feet, then it's just as good as if you jumped on the enemies. Which is how I got a whole bunch of hits on the giant spider there. Because he jumped into my feet several times and it enabled me to kill him. There I go, killing unnecessary enemies again. It enabled me to kill him a lot more quickly than I would otherwise. Who is this character? Is she part of Spelunky or a mod? I believe she's one of the starting characters. I don't know if she actually has a name. I think she's one of the... there are 4 characters in the beginning you can play as. Or maybe she's an unlockable character. I'm not sure. I don't remember. But I got her pretty quickly. So I either started the game with her or I unlocked her quickly. She looks like Wilma. Oh, yeah. Wait. Wilma from the Flintstones? Or do you mean Velma from Scooby-Doo? Because that's who I was thinking. With, you know, the kind of straightish brunette hair and round glasses. Unless there's a different Wilma that I'm not thinking of. Oh god. Oh fuck. Velma, yeah. I always get Velma and Daphne mixed up. To me, Daphne seems like more of a, bookwormish, nerdy girl kind of name. And Velma seems more like a, sexy redhead kind of name. Not that I think that Daphne is sexy, but, you know, that's the intention they were going for. Alright, I don't have as much money as I would like to have at this point, but hopefully it, crap, there's nothing over there. Nothing but death. And lots of it. Ah, crap. Man, I'm down to 2 bombs too, this sucks. I'm really hoping there's more bombs in that box. Because getting to the black market always requires at least 1 bomb. And usually more than 1. So, it's good to have a stockpile. I unfortunately do not. Oh! Crap! Well, where was it? I heard it beep once. Is it closer to this side or is it closer to this side? Well, whatever. Let's just climb out of here and figure out where we're going. Now I'm going to have to reinstall Spelunky and play it again. Says Morris, yeah, man. It's a pretty good time. I go so far as to say that this is my favorite game of the generation. Like, I like it a lot. Why do you have to mess up my party, Frog? Well, the entrance is somewhere near here. I don't think I want to be able to get to it with 1 bomb. Oh no, I was. Okay. Still don't have anywhere near enough money, though. That's kind of a downer. Ah, man, there's 2 crates in there if I had bombs. Shit. Oh, I'm just going to have to get out of here, aren't I? I might have to engage in a little thievery. Are you finishing Potful Mill, or is it a write-off? I'll finish it eventually. I can guarantee that. I mean, if I try to steal the Ankh, I might as well just kill myself. Because there are so many shopkeepers in this level, I'll just immediately die. One trick that I heard is that you can get a... if you get the freeze ray, you can freeze the shopkeepers, jump on their heads, and kill them in 1 hit. But it doesn't look like any of these guys have one of those. I mean, if I had bombs, I could try bombing and getting some of those gems. But I'd have to buy bombs, which would just... I could win a shotgun and then try to kill all the shopkeepers. Still don't think that would work out too well for me, though. Or I could just gamble and try to win enough money to buy the Ankh. I'm never that lucky on this thing, though. Plus, I don't really like spending a lot of time gambling in these streams because I know it's super boring to watch. Now see, if the jackpot was higher, then I would feel better about gambling. Like, I would feel like I actually have a chance. But I mean, the jackpot is only 7,500 gold. That's not enough to do much of anything with. All right. What do you guys say? Okay, I want to keep gambling. And if I can't get enough to buy the Ankh, well, by that point, the ghost probably would have shown up, though. Alright, guys. Murder spree. Oh, man. I was hoping I would win the teleporter. Then I could steal the Ankh and just immediately teleport out. And probably kill myself in the process. Alright. I don't think this is going to happen. But I'm going to take Twisted Little Heart's advice. And... try to go through as slowly and methodically as I can. Of course, with that ghost, I don't know. I kind of... Nope! I never should have angered that shopkeeper. Yeah, well, I didn't have much of a choice. See, this is kind of how the hell runs go. Like, you kind of need everything to be almost perfect if you want to be able to even get to hell. Like, you have to have enough money without, you know, completely blowing all of your resources. Use a rope to get to that crate. It's usually better to spend a rope than a bomb if you have the option. But yeah, a lot more factors to consider in a hell run than in a normal run. But, you know, that kind of makes it more exciting. Because normally I wouldn't even try to fuck with the shopkeepers. Like I am not a person who considers stealing a legitimate strategy. Because the shopkeepers are just so impossible to deal with. I was really hoping there'd be a way to get to that crate. I just wasted so much stuff getting to that. I don't know why I did that. So I traded two ropes and a bomb for three bombs. That's actually not a horrible trade. I'm okay with that. Ropes are not super important. At least not the same way the bombs are. Oh man, there's another crate down there that I didn't even see. That's awesome. And it's bombs. Great. Could not have asked for a better... Well, I could, but you wouldn't have to give it to me. One of the issues I have with GTA is that it gives you this big open world that to do whatever you want and tells you what your character is. Yeah, that's... I can see that. I don't know. I don't have the same... fondness of open world games that I used to, I guess. I don't know. Like, Skyrim was kind of a novelty. Like, it was a really cool looking world. And, like, I don't know. I should have really liked that game, but it did not really do a lot for me. I am looking forward to a new Fallout game just because I love the Fallout setting and I've loved the previous games. But, like, a game being open world in and of itself is not really enough to get me to want to play it. Hey. Thank you. It's a game about being a violent criminal, so personality is a hard character focus. Yeah, I mean, I'm definitely not a fan of Grand Theft Auto, except in the very loosest sense of, you know, blowing stuff up and being stupid. But, you know, now we have Saints Row the Third and Saints Row 4 for that. And it's way better doing that than Grand Theft Auto is. So, no real reason to play those games, in my opinion. Here's the thing. Play Fallout, but set your intelligence to 3 or below. It's hilarious. Yeah, that's what I heard. I don't know. I was really bad at the original Fallout. So, if I did that, I probably wouldn't. I would see even less of that game than I was able to. Yeah. Yay, compass. That's an item I wouldn't buy, but if it's in a crate, I'm happy to get it. I mean, I guess I would buy it if I wasn't trying to save up for the Ankh. I've gotten a lot better at running away when I throw an item to prevent it from falling back down and hitting me in the head. What was that squeak, Duke? The chat room beeps whenever anyone says my name. Oh, fuck. I'm not sure if that's what you mean. I didn't hear any other squeaks. Well, fudge. I'm doing okay on health. No reason to waste resources to get that guy. Doesn't Saints Row have a huge dildo as a weapon? You see, there's another way the Saints Row games have totally made GTA obsolete. Does GTA have a huge dildo weapon? I don't think so. I mean, that's really the main factor I look for in an open world game. The snake level, that's pretty cool. Like I was saying, the snake levels, I don't know how I did not get hit there. I mean, the scorpion jumped right into me. See, that was one of those bullshit moments that if I was playing Joust, then I would have hit the machine and demanded my money back. Not really. Freeze ray. Meh. Other than using it to do that shopkeeper strategy I talked about, not really interested in using the freeze ray for anything. A good 75% of my favorite games this year have been indie games. I didn't play that many new games in 2013. But yeah, I'm in the same boat. Actually, I don't think I played any, like, big AAA games in 2013. I think all the new games I played were indie games. And even then, it wasn't that many of them. Like, there are a bunch of games on my list that I really want to play, but I just haven't gotten around to yet. But yeah, I can't think of a single big AAA game that I played last year. Do 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 do. Doing some mining. Do 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 do. I should get that idol. I don't think there's any shopkeepers or anything below it that I'd be worried about destroying. Ah, crap. No time. No time. Gotta run. Oh, crap. I cannot walk through that wall, Duke. I played some AAA games and indie games that blew me away. I played AAA games and indie games that were just awful. Yeah, it's definitely a mixed bag on both fronts. I don't know. I feel like the indie space has a lot more to offer me personally than the AAA space lately. Like, I'm more interested in playing those types of games. I mean, not that indie is a genre, but you know, the types of games that have been popular with independent game developers, I should say. How do I have 3 health? I thought I had 4. Oh well. Alright, I already have enough for the Ankh, so this is a better run than last time. Just gotta make sure I don't miss the black market again. Assassin's Creed 4 was good. Yeah, and I never got into the Assassin's Creed series. Like, I was kind of excited for the first one when I heard about it. But then it came out, and everyone said it was bad, so I never played it, and I kind of never paid attention to that series since. Like, I know there have been games since that one that people say are good, but it's just not a series that's ever been on my radar since that first one. I mean, part of it is that I'm mostly a PC gamer, and my computer is not good enough to play those kinds of games I thought I could make this jump. Huh, oh well. But my computer isn't, like, if I tried to play the PC version of Assassin's Creed 4, it would probably look really bad. Excuse me, I'm gonna get a drink of water real quick. Alright. Come on, black market. Oh, did I not? I thought I rescued someone that time. I guess not. Fudge. God, I hate frogs. The jumping pattern is so unpredictable. I think I was about to rescue someone, but then I didn't. Story of my life, man. So yeah, other than Spelunky, I haven't really been playing much of anything. I've been playing Super Mario 3D Land on the 3DS. I almost jumped right into those spikes. But that's pretty much just a laundromat game for me. Like, I specifically save it for when I have to do laundry. So, doing laundry isn't so much of a tedious chore. But I'm really enjoying it so far. Well, I say so far, I'm almost done with it. I just made it to World 8 during my last trip to the laundromat. So, I should have it beaten in another week or two. Ooh! I'm glad I came over here. And I have the pickaxe, so hopefully I can uncover the black market without having to spend any bombs. Unless it breaks, which it might. Ooh, I'm close. Oh, there it is. There you are. You tricky little entrance, you. Alright, I have plenty of money too. Sweet. I might be able to get the Ankh and the jetpack. Ooh. Well, look at me. I'm a fancy man. If there's a jetpack for sale. If not, then the Ankh and several bombs would do. Or I might want to get gloves. Thank you, sir. I'm sorry I killed all of those clones of you in another universe. I hope you can forgive me. Alright, how do I spend 34,000 gold? I want to say nothing but bombs. Having a ton of sticky bombs is just so useful. Just a pickaxe in the casino. Well, no jetpack. Alright, what do you want for the gloves? 12,000. As it is, I can get 24 bombs. Or I could get the climbing gloves and 12 bombs. Yeah, I think I'll take the gloves. It's just so useful to have those. Especially in the ice caves. Alright, 7,000. I could buy a bomb bag as well. Actually, I might be able to buy two bomb bags. Was there another one for sale? I forgot. Yeah, here we go. Oh, nope. 200 gold short. Oh, that should be easy enough to get. Here we go. Alright, 24 sticky bombs. That's a good start. That's what I like to call a good start. Alright, stay the hell away from that caveman. Because if he goes nuts and starts attacking people, the shopkeeper might blame me. Even though it's totally not my fault. It's so fucking unfair, man. Both that and the fact that I just got hit by that frog. No, and the frog hit was totally fair. I was not playing to the best of my abilities. I probably could have mined for some more money and bought even more stuff, but I don't have a ton of time. I watched that indie game, The Movie. I wasn't impressed with the developers, with the exception of Edmund. Tommy in particular seemed a total ass. I disagree. I think Tommy is a little socially awkward. Which I can definitely relate to, since I am as well. And social awkwardness can sometimes come across as being an ass. And it's kind of something you have to learn to manage. And he might not be at that point. I mean, he seemed like a good guy to me, though. Like, the way he cared about his family and stuff. He seemed pretty cool. And, you know, everyone says Jonathan Blow is an ass, but I liked him in that movie, too. I don't know. I would have a beer with Jonathan Blow. Except that he probably doesn't drink beer. And I don't really drink beer either. But you know. It's the saying that matters, I guess. Alright. I would definitely feel better about getting some more health. See if I can... Hopefully she doesn't die when she falls. Okay, good. Hopefully I don't die when I fall. Okay, she's safe. I'm not safe. Alright, sorry I had to hit you, but it was for the, Fuck! I knew that was going to happen. Why did I do that? And now I'm not going to be able to get to her without getting hit by the caveman. This sucks. Okay. Still alive. I have one health. That sucks. But I'm still alive. And so is she. So I'm about to have two health. But yeah, I liked everyone in Indie Game the movie. Even Phil Fish. I saw Phil Fish was on a Giant Bomb stream once. I think it was like an E3 event or something. And he just seemed like a really smart, affable dude, like in real life. Despite how he comes across on Twitter. I'm on the wrong side of that woolly mem. I need to be on this side. Oh, I don't like having two hit points, but I'm almost at the mo I had, so pretty soon I won't have to worry about it. Fuck. Especially since, despite harping on about originality, he admits to taking the rewind idea from Ubisoft's Sands of Time. Well, there's a lot more to Braid than just the rewind thing. Oh, fuck! I forgot that the aliens actually hurt you. I thought they were just like the little friendly animal things. Like the penguins. I'm so dumb. I'm so fucking dumb. Oh well. It's been a fun stream anyway, despite my failure. I mean, all games build on ideas from other games. I mean, just look at The Binding of Isaac, for example. I mean, Jesus Christ. I mean, Edmund McMillan has pretty much said that game wouldn't exist if it weren't for Spelunky. I mean, this game pretty much revitalized the whole action roguelike genre. I mean, hell, it practically invented that genre. So, Braid, too deep for you. I really like Braid. That's a really cool game. Mechanically. Like, as for the story, I don't know. It's interesting, I guess. I'm really looking forward to Jonathan Blow's next game, The Witness. He's been working on it for fucking ever. But I guess he's successful enough that he has that luxury now. I don't really know anything about it, except that it's going to be a first-person puzzly kind of game. Which interests me, because I really like games like that. Stream over. No? Did the stream stop? Should still be going. It says live plus recording. Do you guys want the stream to be over? Like, are you bored? Should I call it a night? Crap. Alright, let's see if I'm lead enough to pull this off. Nope. Braid's story is alright, but it tries to pull off something that the genre doesn't support. Yeah, like, the story doesn't really have anything to do with the mechanics or anything, but I mean, it's fine because most video game stories don't. Oh. thought I had that spider. Alright, let's get one more good hell attempt in. And then I'll do today's daily challenge. The daily challenge, I've just been going for as much money as possible. So, I'm not going to try to do the whole hell thing that time. No, you said it has been a good stream. Oh, that was just me reassuring myself. Since I'm very self-conscious. I have to constantly give myself positive reinforcement when I play this game. Or else I'll start crying like a little baby at my repeated failure. Nah, I'm joking. I'm okay. No, it was just a general comment. If you want a good example of the same plot twist, see Silent Hill 2. Never played any of the Silent Hill games. Not a fan of horror as a genre. But I'm thinking maybe I should have played that one, since I just hear so much about it. It's like the best example of a genre. Okay, but yeah, one more good Spelunky run. And by good Spelunky run, I mean I have to make it at least to the ice caves. I'd really like to make it to the temple, at least. City goal would be great. But if I can make it to the ice caves, I'll consider that a successful run, and I'll do the daily challenge. How about that? Sound good? I don't know why I'm negotiating with the audience. Or am I negotiating with myself? Ooh, plot twist. Well, that is a lot of money for just one level. I had to check since I died so many times, I forgot if I was still on 1-1 or not. Hello, Doomwhite. If you're still in the chat room, welcome. Thanks for hanging out. Silent Hill 2 is the best Silent Hill game. Most everyone says 2 is the best. That was a PlayStation 2 game, right? Was it ever remade on anything else? Because I would try to play that game if I had access to it. At least, you know, see what the big deal is. Oh man, the dams was all the way down there. And the altar is all the way up there. I guess I'm doing pretty good on bombs and ropes. So, might as well. Plus, there's some money down here too. Silent Hill 2 was on the PS2. It got a director's cut on Xbox and PC. Oh, there's a PC version? That's cool. Maybe I'll give that a whirl one of these days. Pictures met. Not the best gift ever, but not totally useless, I guess. Because you can do stuff like that. Bam! Nailed that spider. Right between the legs. The old spider dick. Well, I am doing pretty good on money, but I still have to wait and see how much I have by the end. There's also an HD bundle for the 360 PS3, but they're kind of terrible. Well, that sucks. I wonder what HD remakes are going to be in the new console generation. Because, I mean, the games that are being remade are already HD. So what are they going to call them now? Just special edition, I guess? But, I mean, the special edition is, like, the fancy version that comes with the statues and the art books and all that crap that nobody actually wants. And we don't have 4K yet, so they can't call them 4K remakes. Maybe 10 years from now. Every time the bomb is that far down on the spider web, I worry that it's not going to actually kill the spider. Huh? It's the thing about pitcher's mitts, you kind of have to remember that you have them. Yeah, there was a bunch of crap about 4K at the Consumer Electronics Show this year. And, I mean, I get that they need a new gimmick to sell new TVs now that nobody cares about 3D anymore. I just think it's way premature to start worrying about 4K. They could call them remastered versions. Yeah, that's true. Apparently, Sony finally announced their game streaming service. It's going to be called PlayStation Now. They didn't release like price or any actual information about it, when it'll be available or anything. But they at least announced it, which I guess that's cool. I mean, I'm pretty skeptical that it'll work. Since OnLive really didn't seem to work that well, but I don't know. I guess it's worth waiting to see what they come up with. Right. I saw the... Oh. I'm gonna have to use, like, two bombs and... or a bomb and two ropes. And I want to sacrifice the damsel. The pug. I guess it's worth it. Well, it might be worth it the first time around, but if I can get two of them, it's definitely worth it. The Kapala is one of the best items in the game. Alright, I can either bomb my way down or go down and then use a rope to get back up. I think I'll just bomb. I don't want to risk pissing off that spider if I don't have to. Since I already have the paste. Oh yeah, I already did a sacrifice this run. Excellent. Well, maybe now I will try to kill that spider. Just so I can drink its precious, precious fluids. The problem with the Kapala is that you have to actually physically touch the blood if you want to get the health regen from it. I thought it was just you kill an enemy and it slowly fills the thing up, but you have to actually touch the physical blood droplets, which kind of sucks. It's not as easy to get health as I thought. I'm gonna have to use another bomb to get that damn key. There's no other way to get in there, is there? Fuck, I'm running out of time. I stop dicking around. I hate being that this low on bombs when I haven't gotten to the black market yet. Alright, Ghost. I knew we could work together. Rather than seeing updated graphics, I would sooner see re-releases that reinstate cut content. Cut rooms, cut items, cut quests, and such. Yeah, I think the PC version of Deadly Premonition had a bunch of stuff like that. A bunch of stuff that wasn't in the original releases. But yeah, that's cool. I would like to see more stuff like that. I heard the PC version of Deadly Premonition is not good in other ways, though. Which kind of sucks. Like, it runs way worse than it should. From what I've heard. Could just be, you know, one person with a bad experience reporting on it. Never know. God, I hate fucking tiki traps. Worst trap in the game. I hate piranhas too. I never feel confident about my ability to kill a piranha. Like, there are times where I shot a piranha in the face with a shotgun and it did not kill it. Wow, I'm really glad that didn't piss off that shopkeeper. That could have been, that could have been bad. But yeah, I don't know what it is about the piranhas that make them so damn survivable. This is just 2-1, right? Okay, yeah. The original version of Deadly Premonition wasn't well optimized to begin with. Yeah, but you think the PC version should run at least as well as a 360 version. And from what I hear, it didn't. I don't have any bombs. I'm gonna have to lure this frog over. But it's not gonna work because he's gonna fall in the water and lose his explosiveness. No. I was gonna say maybe not, but of course I should have paid more attention to that shopkeeper. I think he had bombs for sale. I'm so dumb. Well, see if there's any way. Bombs! Oh, yes. Oh, I'm so lucky. I need to try harder to fill up my cup, too. All right. Whew. Man, I'm glad I lucked out and found those bombs. Oh, man, there's a crate and a damsel down there. I think that's worth it. Especially if the crate has more bombs. It didn't. It had more ropes. Ooh, I don't think I have an easy way to get to that damsel either. Okay. Yeah, that worked out. Well, it's been 2 hours, but I'm having a good time. I don't know about you guys. Oh man. Don't piss off the shopkeepers, please. Okay. I didn't think it was close enough to be an issue, but you never know with this damn game. Sometimes it can surprise you. Alright, I have enough for a bomb crate. That would probably be my best move. Since I only have one bomb. Like, seriously? I don't know what I'm going to do if I actually get to hell. Because it's going to be damage if I fall, isn't it? Oh, I forgot I had to shoot. I don't know what I'm going to do if I do get to hell, because I mean, I can't kill Olmec without using all my bombs and all my ropes. At least that's been the case so far. It'd be cool if I won enough money to get the jetpack. Or spring shoes, I'll take them. Why not? Why the heck not? Paste, I already have that. Deadly Premonition began as a PS2 game, and it absolutely shows. I don't mind, because I've never been sold on graphics, but you'd expect a PS3 to run stuff designed for its baby sister. Yeah, I'm the same way. Like, I don't care about the graphics in that game, but it would be nice if those sections ran a little smoother. And apparently there's no improvement on the PC. Or so I've heard. Alright. Should probably quit while I'm technically ahead. A little proctological. Aw, man. Worst place for a tiki trap ever. And I missed that piranha. Okay. I forgot when you have the pitcher's glove, the bombs fly out in a straight line as well. That's kind of interesting. Definitely changes up some strategies a little bit. Come on, jump. You know you wanna. No? Okay. Fuck! I tried to land on the frog's head, but it did not work. That's okay. I had the Kapala. Probably saying that word completely wrong, too. I apologize to any pedants who are worried about that kind of thing. I might be pronouncing that word wrong, too. I don't know. I might be pronouncing everything wrong. My whole life could be a lie. Like, the other day, I learned that remuneration isn't a word. Like, when someone gets paid for something, I thought they get remunerated. But it's actually remunerated. R-E-M-U-N-E-R-A-T-I-O-N. Alright, see you later, Koss. And I'm like, damn. See, if it's remuneration, that kind of makes sense because of the connection with money and numerals. Like, you got paid with this numeral, this number of dollars. But if it's remuneration, I don't know what the root of that word is. And it's confusing me and hurting my little brain. You know, I don't know what happens if you sacrifice someone when you already have the Kapala. I've never had the opportunity to do it before. I think I'm going to try. It's probably not worth the risk, but I'm really curious. Actually, I don't know if I can blow up that mammoth without pissing Callie off at the same time. I'll try. Phew! That's close. Alright. Nothing. Come on. Oh, crap. Oh. It's a good thing I made that sacrifice, because otherwise, when that alien blew up that altar, it would have spawned a lot of angry spiders. But, I sacrificed enough an extra person and, earned extra favor with her. Well, that didn't work out. Alright, well, let's see if I can turn this into an Olmec kill. And after that, I'll do the daily challenge. I'm staying up well past my bedtime. Well, no. I mean, if I just go to bed... Crap! I'm in the same shitty area. Where the fuck is the exit? It's not over here. Is it? Oh, yeah. I guess it is. Whew. Alright, well, I'm sorry I wasn't able to show off Hell or the City of Gold. But I think it's been an entertaining and informative stream nonetheless. Fuck. I thought I could get away from the UFO before it blew up. But I couldn't get away in time. Alright, daily challenge time. Like I said, I'm not going to worry about doing a hell run this time around. I'm just going for score. I mean, technically, if I did try for a hell run, of course. If I did try for a hell run, that could be good for my score in the long run. Because if I make it to the City of Gold, that's like a huge amount of money I could potentially get. But I would have to risk a 50,000 gold investment to buy the Ankh first. And I don't think that's an investment that would pay dividends in my case. Alright, see you later, CPC Gamer. Thanks a lot for coming out, man. I haven't seen you around much. It's good to catch up. And it's a dark level. I actually don't mind dark levels that much if it's the mines, because they're not that difficult, and it's a good chance to get a lot of money. I did not even see that spider. Oh god. Oh, Jesus. Fuck. See, it's actually helpful when the giant spider shoots web at you. Because it makes it easier to get hits on it. I'm glad it does that. Crap. I'm trying to get that gem up there, but I won't stick to that web. Oh well. This is probably going to be a very short challenge run, sadly. Oh, is this a snake level too? Yeah, that makes sense. Another chance to get a good bit of money, I guess. Alright, that trap was triggered. Too many items I have to juggle. The torch, the pug, and the pickaxe. Sounds like a really dumb, boring crime novel. Possibly from France. The pug, the torch, and the pickaxe. How are these items connected? Read this shitty novel and find out. That was my French accent. Alright. Definitely running short on time here, but I have a pretty good feel for the... Well, fuck. Never mind. I would have liked to bring that pickaxe with me, but no time. Or mattock, I guess it's technically called. Well, at least I didn't die as soon as I was worried I would die. I took a lot of damage there at the beginning of the game. Oh, fuck. Another big spider. Great. Well, I guess I'll go this way then. I don't really like the purple spiders that dangle down from the web. I don't feel like they're thematically consistent. I mean, they weren't in classic Spelunky. They added them for the HD version. But it's not just that. Like, the little spiders and the giant spiders, you can kind of see the connection between them. Like, they look like they're part of the same species. And the purple spiders are just... they look like they're from a different game, almost. Which, I guess, technically, they are. They're from Spelunky HD. So yeah, I kind of gave up on Hearthstone. It was the other game I was playing for a while. And I have fun with it sometimes. I'm just really, really, really bad at it. Oh, fuck off. So yeah, I haven't touched that in a while. Like, sometimes I have a pretty good run, but not very often. Like, I haven't gotten more than 4 wins in an arena game. Which, the arena is like the, fuck. It's like the, sealed deck tournament in Magic. Where you kind of have to build your deck on the fly. I'm just no good at that at all. I was going to go for the chest, but why not? It's a challenge. Or why should I? It's a challenge run. There's no reason to go to the black market here. I could go to the worm level again, but I don't think that's really worth it. I don't think there's more treasure there than there is anywhere else. Yeah, I'm not even looking at the shops, really. Since I'm going for score, I want to kind of save as much money as possible. This is a really bad level layout, because I can't bomb my way through the shop. I'm gonna have to go around, which means I'm gonna have to use like 4 bombs to get through here without pissing off the shopkeeper. That really sucks. Fuck. Okay, well, maybe not as many bombs as I thought I would. Ooh, okay. That works. So, 3 bombs. Meh. I hate the water levels. They're just so difficult to navigate. I do wonder if it's possible to actually go into the water and survive, though. I mean, I'm sure it is, because anything is possible in this game. I've just never seen it done. I wonder if killing the big fish actually gives you anything good. Whew. I thought that was the end of me. God, it's a piranha in every goddamn pond. Hello, Enhanced Wizard. How's it going? Thanks for coming to the stream. Oh, crap. Man. I really want to save that guy because I only have 1 hit point. So, going to utilize a bomb as much as I don't want to. fuck. If I bounce on that guy's head, I'm gonna bounce directly into that bat. See if I can. Oh! Oh god. So many close calls this game. Jesus Christ. Should probably try to get that boomerang. That'd be helpful to have. Nope. Never mind. I'll take a rock with me. I'm doing fine. Haven't had a successful run tonight, but it's been a fun time. Fuck. Fuck. See, I never know how to predict the behavior of the cavemen and the boomerang guys. Like, I thought for sure that boomerang guy was going to turn around. I'm dead. Nope. Fuck, now I'm dead. Alright, well, that wasn't completely terrible. 58,000 gold. Hey, I'm number 156 in the world. I'm sure that's going to change pretty soon. Since this run, today's daily challenge just rolled over a couple hours ago. Alright, well, I think that's a successful stream. Well, not successful, but that's a finished stream. Thanks to everyone who came. I hope you had a good time. I will probably do this again pretty soon. So yeah, take care everyone. See you next time. Good night.